Thousands of Iraqi security forces and allied Shiite and Sunni militias retook control of the town of Himrin earlier this week. Himrin is located southeast of the city of Tikrit, capital of Salah ad-Din province, some 170 kilometers north of Baghdad. The troops, supported by air forces, also took positions around Tikrit itself, as well as the town of Dor. Fierce clashes continue to recapture the redoubts of the IS militants across the province. The Iraqi security forces and parliamentary forces are fighting like lions with the Islamic State militants. We are now encircling them. We will pursue these extremists to the very end and let Saladin province become their graves. Despite constant strikes against the terrorists, the group remains a formidable force. And there's a long way to go before IS is finally eliminated. IS, an al-Qaeda splinter group, has alarmed the international community by swiftly overtaking vast swaths of territory in Syria and northern Iraq. It has imposed a draconian set of laws on the region. The group has become synonymous with brutality, beheading international journalists, and posting videos of the killings on social media. The birth of IS was partly due to the U.S.'s Middle East policy. The new anti-terror coalition proposed by President Barack Obama has limited membership into the coalition. It has alienated countries it dislikes out of geopolitical and global strategic considerations, which weakens the capacity of the coalition as a result. Meanwhile, the U.S. and its allies adopted airstrikes as a principal tool to hit IS. Because of a lack of coordination between airstrikes and ground forces, the IS has consistently transferred its forces to other safe areas. As a result, days of intensive bombing have only had a limited effect. The IS is also skilled at promoting terrorism and extremism through a variety of channels. Videos it uploads to the internet contain English subtitles. And a great number of young people have been lured away in the name of religion to participate in jihad in the Middle East. The fight against terrorism is a battle for the long run. The international community needs to take a multi-pronged approach in order to defeat the IS. That approach must be a political, security, economic, financial, and information-sharing one in order to remove the breeding ground of terrorism.